All right, it is Friday, January the 8th of 2010, and this is your Daily Dose. We'll start with your DAP. Your DAP on the board back there says Safe Access Club members. Next week, remember we showed the sample board? Well, there'll be another board up next week, trying to get people more in line with what's coming out there for you. We already have one dispensary that's acting as if. I've seen multiple ads for at least three more that I know of coming. Not to mention, well, the Safe Access Club and things like that. So I just wanted to let everybody know that next week I'll have sample board of a dispensary menu here in the office. So just wanted to let that know. Now, your quotes for today come from Ralph Waldo Emerson. And the first quote says, "What you are comes to you." In other words, good begets good, evil begets evil. The next quote says, "This time, like all times, is a very good one, if we but know what to do with it." And then the last quote says, "With the past, I have nothing to do, nor with the future. I live now." It's that simple. Now, for your dosage today, a couple of things to talk about. First, patients have been asking about renewals, how it works. Well, what I found out so far is it seems that the state has started sending out renewal packets to people. It looks like 60 to 75 days prior to your expiration date. So I've actually had a couple of patients that actually get the packet. There's no finger card, no fingerprint card in the packet. All you have to do, two notarized forms, the attending physician statement, which if you've used our service, your renewal, it was $150, the doctor fee. I believe for renewal is $100, but I'm not 100% sure on that. I'm pretty sure it is, though. And then you're $150 to the state. So if you're an MCCNV patient, your renewal cost will be $250 because your notary, if you use our service, is free for life after you use our service. So as long as I have a notary license and you're renewing your stuff for the MPP or the MMP, I'm sorry, come on down. Notary's on me if you used our service. It's that simple. So basically your renewals runs you about $250, maybe a little more depending on postage, cost of envelopes, whatnot. But $250, $100 for the doctor, maybe $150, and then $150 to the state. So it's either $250 or $300 if you're renewing through MCCMV. So I wanted to go ahead and put that out there. Now, the next thing I want to talk about, I've gotten a lot of questions, a lot of responses about the dispensary and about the coming of dispensaries, and people are worried about greedy and they don't think it's right and they're not sure. And I want to clarify something, because people say, well, shouldn't we wait for the law to change before this happens? And well, here's the deal. If we were to sit around and wait for everything that the law or the government was going to give to us, guess what? We'll be waiting until hell freezes over to get our rights. The state constitution in Nevada has had this in it since 2001. And we still don't have safe access or appropriate methods of supply for patients that are licensed to use it. So with that being said, yeah, you're right. There is a gray area where people are breaking the law. But you know what? It's like this. If somebody had you caged up in your house and was beating you every day and you knew that it was against the law and they told don't break out, but you knew what they were doing was against the law, you were eventually either going to, one, die like a little coward in that cage, or two, you're going to fight back. And guess what? I think waiting from 2001 until 2009 and then basically now 2010, that's waiting long enough. The fact that we even waited this long is still too long. So am I upset that people are opening and that it seems a little greedy because of the prices they're charging? No, I watched it happen in other states. I'll watch it happen here. The fact is this, good begets good, evil begets evil. And there's no way that a medical marijuana patient should be paying anywhere between $70 to $90 for anything, whether it be a gram of hash, an eighth of medicine, whatever it is. And they shouldn't be giving up photocopies of their ID, simply a name and a patient number. It's that simple. It's not our job to keep those records. The state keeps all those records. So as long as they're a licensed patient with a patient number, let them decide who's active and who isn't. But as far as all this talk of like, we should wait until the law changed. No, you have to make change. Be the change you want to see. And it's not that I agree with a $90 eighth or a $10 brownie that doesn't do anything for you. The point is this, you have money. You decide how you spend it. So if you go into a place and you leave your money behind and you leave with a product and you're a dissatisfied customer, don't go back. If you're not happy, then open your own. But also understand this. Most people that are making these comments about how it might suck or how it's good that you're looking at the big picture, but somebody has to do it. And they're going to have costs and they're going to have overhead associated with that risk. And that's what they're going to do. They're going to cover their ass. That's what business people do. They have to run a business. And they have to run a business that keeps customers coming in. So if their pricing keeps you away from them, then great. Just know this. There is many more coming, regardless of what the law says. We should already have safe access. It's honestly a moral obligation ever since we put what we put into the state constitution back in 2001. So yeah, there are going to be some that are greedy. Guess what? There's some places that charge $2 for a cheeseburger when I know that McDonald's got a 99-cent menu. People still pay $2 for the cheeseburger. It's that simple. Now, as far as the legality goes, we understand we can't be legal in dispensing medication and receiving compensation for our work. We understand that we ignore the United States Constitution. We understand that we ignore Nevada State Constitution. It's cool. Happens all the time. As I get older, I realize that that Constitution is just something that kept my attention span during 40 minutes in sixth grade. It's all good. You live and you learn. Just know this. Whether it's legal or not, dispensaries are much needed. There's hundreds of patients right now with nowhere to go but the illicit market. And I'm going to do my best to help them, and I'm glad to see that other people are trying to. If their intentions aren't the same as mine, eventually that will be exposed. That's cool. Just know this. I am always willing to treat people with respect and courtesy, and definitely treat them with respect and courtesy because they're a medical marijuana patient. It's that simple. Those of you who know me know this. And if you're out of line, well, I have no problem telling people that you're out of line and I can't help you. It's that simple. But yes, I'm in favor of dispensing collectives. However, as long as the patients have access to their medicine, if you're going to profit on it, great. You can make money to keep your store running, but that's not how I'm doing it. I'm not saying that what I'm doing is right or what they're doing is wrong. I'm just saying that like everything else, everybody has a choice to decide what they associate themselves with. Hopefully, you'll decide what you want to associate with, and that's what you'll be associated with. But just know this. I will continue to help patients. There's always the Safe Access Club, and like the DAP says, there'll be a menu next week. It is what it is. Hopefully people use it for what they can use it for. Now, or something else I wanted to talk about. As far as the partnerships and all that everyone's been asking, it's like this. I'm a consultant. There are many people that came in this office and said, hey, look, how do I do what I want to do? And guess what? I told them. And it's like I told all of them, hey, there's a free agent right here. I'll be more than happy to help take you there. And some listen, and some offer, and some, hey, you know, thanks for the advice, so on and so forth. It's all good. What people don't realize is, and I've said this before, as long as there is more and more places for patients to get medicine, for patients to get help getting their card, for patients to get their legal rights, for patients to do whatever it is that they need to do to have life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, that's what I'm here for. So when all of these different things happen and people ask me, well, oh, are they going to put you out of business? Are you scared? Know this, whether I have an office or not, whether or not I participate in this wonderful world of capitalism, all right, it's not about money for me. Whatever happens, I win. And that's just my point of view. So it does no good for you guys to ask what I think. Look, anything that proliferates the ability of a licensed medical marijuana patient to have quality of life, I'm all for it. It's that simple. It's real easy to tell where I stand. If you're not sure, ask me. But I just want to let everybody know there is dispensaries, whether you like them or not, find one you like because they'll be coming along. And eventually we'll have to stretch the laws around to do it. Look at California, look at Colorado. It's going to happen. But I just wanted to let everybody know how I felt. I wanted to let everybody know about how you renew. You got your quotes. Everybody have a great, safe, and happy weekend. Don't forget. Oh, snap. All right, guys. We'll see you next week. I'll probably do some videos this weekend. But if not, we'll see you Monday. Have a great weekend. Can't wait to show you that menu on Monday. Well, actually, it'll be next week, but it'll probably be Monday. All right, guys, have a great weekend.